Good morning, church.
Good morning.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
And also with you.
Announcements this morning. Once again, Lois McNeil is at the rehab facility in Chelsea, Michigan. But you can send cards to her house. We will be collecting socks, underwear. Do you want to say anything about that?
We have a beautiful box back there to receive them. And there are a couple of things in there already, and people are doing their shopping. So you have like 3 weeks. December 12th is the last day to bring them. They will be taking them to Associated Charities.
All right, really good. And we will be doing the Christmas cookie pass in Clayton on the 11th, Saturday the 11th. So please bake some cookies and let us know if you can help. And thanks to Denver for getting us all organized with where everything goes. We appreciate that. And we will be having a Christmas party on the 5th on Sunday, and that will be a potluck. And $1 gift exchange, so bring the plan on doing that if you can. Newsletter deadline, what's your plans, Barb?
Oh, I just got home.
Okay.
Let's see, when is the deadline? Today?
Today. Okay. Friday afternoon it is. You betcha.
So I really do need things today.
Yep.
If possible.
Okay. All right.
And yeah, just the front page. I'd appreciate that too. That is the hardest one to do.
We could do the front page. Oh, no, we can't.
Okay. That we need to make. Then please wave at, greet each other with a wave, knowing that God loves each and every one of you. Good morning, good morning. And let us pray. Come, rest from your struggles, your worries, and your work. May the Lord of love reign above every earthly power and in our hearts as well, as we prepare our hearts for worship. Amen. Let us open our hymnals to page 821, Psalm 100, 1 through 5, and we'll do the first response. Joyful noise to the Lord, all the lands.
Serve the Lord with us. Come to God's presence.
Know that the Lord who made us is God.
We are the Lord's. We are the people of God. The sheep of God's pasture.
Enter God's gates with thanksgiving and God's courts with praise.
Give thanks to the Lord's name.
For the Lord is good.
God's steadfast love endures forever. God's faithfulness to all generations.
Rejoice. Let us stand now and sing number 694, Come Ye Thankful People Come, verses 1, 2, and 3.
Thank you.
seated. And let us share our joys and concerns this morning. Where have you seen God at work this week in your life? Yes, Dennis.
Well, I see that way Christian won the state championship, and Hudson come from halftime 22-point deficit to back to win their game. So they'll be in the finals next Saturday, or next Friday.
So we lift up Lunaway Christian, maybe, Donna, I think you all went.
We did. We drove to Marquette. Yeah, it was a great game. So state champs, back-to-back.
Back-to-back champs.
Jake takes stats, so he was up in the box. So, yeah, so we drove the 7 hours up there to watch him win and drove 7 hours back.
Well, we give thanks for your safety and... but also for back-to-back wins for the boys' football game.
Yeah.
Lord, in your mercy. Thank you, Dennis. And how about the girls' volleyball?
They made it to quarterfinals and lost, but that was a great season. You know, they're very young. They're only losing one off the team. So we have high hopes for next year.
Fantastic. So we lift all of them. The sports teams, and especially the volleyball girls, Lord, in your mercy. Thank you. Any others? Well, I understand someone had a flat tire and managed to get things fixed and on their way. And,
that's the most expensive flat tire I've ever run into. But there are good people out there. I mean, we just got to Jackson and got on the road in good time, and I won't go into all the details, but I've never had a tire blow out like that. I mean, it went bang in the front and dropped right down onto the ground. I thought we probably lost the tire is what I thought, but anyway, throughout the whole ordeal, I had four different people stop. One guy, he stuck with me for a half an hour trying to get that tire out from underneath that pickup. Those things you're supposed to crank down on the cable and what have you, they just don't work right. We got her off. You get the right equipment, you will take care of anything.
Yep. That's true. We give thanks for our safety, especially. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayers.
Come from Sally Mandel, your cousin. Stage 1 cancer.
Yes, my cousin in Massachusetts, stage 1 cancer. So we want to lift up Sally Randall. Lord, in your mercy. Yes, Don.
Kim mentioned this, that we have one of my accountants in my office that has a brain tumor. He's 36. He's got two kids that are in 6th grade and 8th grade. It's definitely cancerous. You know, the prognosis is not good at all. So he's at UMM, he's in some research studies, he's starting chemo and radiation, but if you could keep him in your prayers, I really appreciate it.
Is that Matt?
Matt Wetzel is his name. Yeah, mm-hmm. Matt Wetzel is his name.
We lift up Matt for healing and for prayers for him. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayers.
Thank you. Yes, Bill.
Communicated with Deb Strager the other day. And ask her how Jim Dickerson's doing, and she says he isn't grooming, and they're prepared to take him off of that.
So we lift up Jim, and we know that Deb's been taking Sally down to the hospital every day. And so we lift up Jim for continued healing. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayers.
Any others? Well, we give thanks for Thanksgiving, and it's time to gather families together and to give thanks. Lord, in your mercy. And let us lift up to God those things that are deep in our hearts in silent prayer. O holy God, all good gifts around us are sent from heaven above. So we lift up our hearts to you, O God, in praise and thanksgiving. We count our blessings and acknowledge your goodness, and our hearts go out to those who are in need. We thank you for plentiful harvests and full refrigerators and ask that you help us supply the needs of those who are hungry. We thank you for jobs that provide for our families and pray that you would care for those who have no work or the dignity and purpose that it brings. We thank you for family and friends who love us and care for us and pray that you would help us befriend those who are alone. The abundance of the harvest is a symbol of the abundance of your love in our lives. And out of your love, may we live in a spirit of gratitude toward our neighbors, who are all your sacred children. May we live in a spirit of gratitude toward our neighbors who are of sacred worth, who embody the image of you, Holy God. It is this sacred image that we honor when we're able to express our gratitude. We especially give thanks for the doctors and nurses caring for those on our prayer list and those who suffer. We give thanks to the teachers and librarians and school counselors and school staff. May this week be a rest renewed, that they may renew their souls. We give thanks to the frontline workers and those who provide our food and clean water. We pray for those who risk their lives to keep us safe and those who work to bring peace to the streets. Loving God, in this season and all year long, give to us the gift of thankful hearts, that we may acknowledge you as the giver of all that is good in our lives. And we pray this all in the name of the one who showed us an example of faithful gratitude, Christ our Lord, who taught us to pray, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen." Let's consider our offering. O Spirit of life and love, reign in us today. And use these gifts, the fruit of our labor, to make your church an instrument of peace for the world. May we not rest until your peaceable kingdom reigns in every heart. Move us this day to feed the hungry, to befriend the lonely, protect the afflicted, and proclaim Christ's love to all of your creation. So let us stand and sing our praises to God as we stand to give our song.
Praise God from whom the blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above the heavenly host. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost.
God of majesty and power, you have dominion over all the universe, and yet you choose to rule not in power but in love. The gifts that we give you are not from fear or in petition for your favor, but in the deepest gratitude for all your blessings that keep us and sustain us. May our whole lives reflect to the world that there is one who rules us with love and compassion above all this world's nations and principalities. In the name of your Son, the Christ, we pray. Amen. Let us stand and sing number 92, For the Beauty of the Earth, verses 1, 2, and 6.
Over.
Your scripture this morning is Psalm 103. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and do not forget all of his benefits, who forgives all of your iniquity and heals all of your diseases, who redeems your life from the pit, who crowns you with steadfast love and mercy, who satisfies you with good as long as you live, so that your youth is renewed like the eagles. The Lord works vindication and justice for all who are oppressed. He makes known his ways to Moses, his acts to the people of Israel. The Lord is merciful and gracious, slow to anger, abounding in steadfast love. He will not always accuse, nor will he keep his anger forever. He does not deal with us according to our sins, nor repay us according to our iniquities. For as the heavens are high above the earth, so great is his steadfast love toward those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far as he removes our transgressions from us. And as a father who has compassion for his children, so the Lord has compassion for those who fear him. For he knows how we were made, and he remembers that we are dust. As far as mortals, their days are like grass. They flourish like a field of the flower of the field. For the wind passes over it, and it is gone, and its place knows it no more. But the steadfast love of the Lord is from everlasting to everlasting on those who fear him, and his righteousness to children's children, to those who keep his covenant and remember to do his commandments. The Lord has established his throne in the heavens, and his kingdom rules over all. Bless the Lord, O you his angels, you mighty ones who do his bidding, obedient to the spoken word. Bless the Lord, all the his hosts, his ministers that do his will. Bless the Lord, all his works, in all places of his dominion. Bless the Lord, O my soul. The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Pray with me. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of all our hearts be acceptable to you, O Lord, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. A teacher asked her class, if there were 11 sheep in a field and 6 jumped over the fence, how many would be left? None, a boy replied. Oh, of course they would, the teacher said. No, ma'am, there wouldn't. You may know math, but you don't know sheep. Some people have mastered the art of thanksgiving and living out of a sense of gratitude for all of God's blessings. They're able to mine the silver and gold from the messiest of circumstances. Occasionally, I'll read the scripture lesson from the 103rd Psalm at the end of a hospital visit to someone who has shared the blessing of God's healing presence. The words of this psalm expresses the thanksgiving that people feel after recovering from illness or surgery. Such natural moments of thanksgiving help us to forget not all of God's benefits. Psalm 103 speaks to our need to remember that we are blessed and that we need to be open to the power of God's presence throughout the day. Forget not all God's benefits. Who forgives? Well, St. Paul wrote, blessed are those whose transgressions are forgiven, whose sins are covered, in Romans 4:7. We're thankful for God's forgiving grace that frees us to live in peace. We have experienced the Heavenly Father's loving arms around us when we've gone astray like the prodigal son. We're thankful whenever we see the cross of Jesus. And we give thanks to God for tending to us, for hearing our confessions, and accepting us for who we are now, but also loving us for who we may become. We thank God for the means of grace through Holy Communion and baptism, and we're thankful for the belonging to the house of God and being a sheep in the flock of the Good Shepherd through Jesus Christ. Forget not all God's benefits, who heals. The Gospel of Matthew observed news of Jesus spread, and people brought to him all who were ill, and he healed them. We give thanks for the sense of feeling mysteriously nurtured. We notice that there are times when we are strengthened to go in and to go on and to seek a healing balm whenever we're ill. We notice that we are surrounded by nature and we feel healthier and more energized. We are grateful for times of prayer and worship when we sense the presence of the Holy Spirit as a spirit of healing, and wisdom, and love. We're thankful for those healthcare workers who are giving and sacrificing so much during this pandemic. It's truly inspiring how many are giving so much for so many and for all of our safety. Forget not God's benefits, who redeems your life from the pit. The psalmist offers a thanksgiving, writing in Psalm 40, 1 and 3. I waited patiently for the Lord, who inclined to me and heard my cry. And the Lord drew me up from the desolate pit, out of the miry bog, and set my feet upon a rock, making my steps secure. The Lord put a new song in my mouth, a song of praise to our God. Thank God for the presence of God that clearly wants us to bloom and fulfill our potential. We sense God on our side, encouraging us to strive and to grow. We are thankful that no matter how trapped we become, we're also aware of redeeming energy at work to free us. We give thanks for our knack of doing our best at the worst times and our courage to act in the scariest of predicaments. We join today with St. Paul, who proclaims, "Praise to the God and Father of Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of compassion and the God of all comfort, who comforts us in our troubles so that we can comfort those in any trouble." Forget not God's benefits, who satisfies you with good. We give thanks for the abiding sense that God is with us and working for us and the good in us and in the world. The Apostle Paul reminds us, rejoice in the Lord always. The Lord is near. Do not worry about anything, but in everything, by prayer and thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. We thank God for our skill at finding the best in every circumstance. And we give thanks for our desire to strive for what lies beyond our grasp and our inclination to stretch ourselves. Forget not all God's benefits. Whoever renews your youth like the eagles. We thank God every morning for new beginnings and new opportunities to soar. The Bible affirms, because of the Lord's great love, we were not consumed, for his compassion never fails. They are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness. We give thanks for our unflappable hope against the odds. We thank God for our irrepressible playfulness and our sense of humor. And we're grateful for our reluctance to accept defeat or accept abuse from others. Because of all of God's benefits, we do not give up on ourselves and others. As we remember those benefits, we realize the great magnitude of our blessings. Through thanksgiving and gratitude, we open ourselves to the power and the blessings of the presence of God in our lives and in our world. I recall as a young boy being fascinated by a particular tool in my dad's toolbox. It was a large bar of steel that was a powerful magnet. It held a mysterious power of attraction, and I would string nails from one end up and around to the other. Or I would pick up nearly invisible metal shavings from the workbench. It was particularly helpful in retrieving small nuts and bolts from the floor or Dad's workbench. Or another magnet would snap into place at one end or be pushed away on the other. Thanksgiving is also a useful tool in retrieving God's resources for us, for attracting those resources to us. When we remember all of God's benefits, we realize that we gather the blessings that God has provided in every circumstance. So bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all God's benefits. Amen. Let us turn to Thank We All Our God, number 102. Please stand.
Thanksgiving.